It's so beautiful out here. Lake Kebab, Kebab, however it's pronounced. Man, it's beautiful. Nothing like Arizona forests. I could sit here all day and just enjoy the scenery. Man, I could sit here for hours. But unfortunately, I'm part of Gen Z, and Gen Z is incapable of standing still for more than 10 minutes. God, our generation sucks. Alright, where should I go next? Somebody left their backpack. What is that? What is that? Hello? Sir? What are you? Oh, my skin burns! Oh, my skin burns. What, Clyde? Oh, nothing. Clyde, you obviously have something to share with me. So what is it? Oh, nothing. Nothing important. Huh? I didn't say anything. Oh. Okay. Clyde, what do you want? Aliens are real. I found one out in Arizona, in the magical forest.
You're the most stupidest person I know, and if I had a penny for every stupid thing you've ever done, I'd be Hollywood itself. You're an idiot, Clyde. You and, what the?
Yeah. That's my pet alien right there. But don't touch his skin. Cause he's hot. Like a model who's trapped in a house fire. But the house burnt down. And even the old grandma died. It was sad. And I went to her funeral though. And it was what were we talking about again?
An actual alien.
Holy crap. A real life alien. Ah! Oh my. Blaze, you really need a hearing aid. So, where are you from?
So, can you not talk?
Blaze, obviously he can't talk, or he would have said something by now. Jesus, he's not Ryan Seacrest. He's a version of Ryan Seacrest that has throat cancer. Clyde, shut up. He's like, he's Helen Keller because he can't speak.
Helen Keller talked?
Oh. Well, he's like a version of Helen Keller that was Val Kilmer.
Clyde, if you do not shut your butt, I'm going to blow my brains out, because I would rather die of a gunshot wound than have my brain die of stupidity.
All right.
How? Oh.
Blaze, you can't do that! Please don't!
Clyde, I don't feel safe. I don't have a choice.
I promise he's a nice guy.
I know he's a nice guy, Clyde, but you found him in Arizona, which connects to Nevada. And he could have came from Area 51. The government could be after him. And I don't want to get in trouble. I don't want to be locked up because I interfered with an alien.
What? I don't understand.
I don't trust the government.
Then why are you calling the government in the first place?
Because I feel like if we call the government now, then they'll let us off the hook.
I mean, but what if they erase our minds anyway, Blaze? I mean, think about it. You were just saying about yourself. You don't trust the government. They keep dark secrets away from us. So why should we tell them anything? I mean, there's no telling what they would do to us after they find out about the alien. And, Jesus, they keep dark secrets away from us. So we should keep this dark secret away from them.
The only thing is, Clyde, I kinda already texted them.
Oh. Knowing the government, they're probably just going to ignore it.
Well, not like this. If it involves something like this, they'll definitely see it. It's when it just involves our lives and stuff. We're just numbers to the government, so they wouldn't do anything. But this involves an alien, so...
Well, there's someone outside.
Told you.
Hold on. It could be McDonald's.
Nobody ordered McDonald's.
What if I did on accident?
You're an idiot.
There's a guy with, sunglasses on and a suit and tie.
Yeah. Government.
No, wait. He's taking off his suit and tie. He's putting regular clothes on. I think he's trying to blend in with society.
Or what they call inferiors.
You know, not gonna lie. Not a bad looking guy.
Sorry, Clyde. I have to answer this.
What? No! No! Come on, we gotta hide you somewhere.
Come on.
My name is Don Harvey. I work for the government. Can I come in?
Yeah, come right on in.
Are you the one who called about the alien?
Yeah. The alien is right over here. Huh? No. No alien here. Nope.
Okay. Well, if you do see an alien, just know that it's only your own imagination. And we will not be taking it to Area 51, which is not the area that I came from, because the area doesn't exist.
I told you.
Okay.
What's all the whispering about?
Nothing. I just... have to poop.
Hey.
You got something you want to tell me, Clyde? Really? You wanna see some footage of you and the alien that I took near the Sycamore Falls out in Arizona? Phone's ringing. Where are it's at? Gotta go. Probably in the car. It's probably my smartwatch ringing.
Yeah. Maybe you should go.
Oh, and Clyde, one more thing. That alien that you have, wherever it is, it's not gonna survive on this planet. Its atmosphere here is way different than the atmosphere that they have. Ever wonder why his skin burns?
Okay. We're good, alien! Oh my god. Now I can't even contact the government, because they know... I can't even... This is bad. This is bad. I don't know what to do. We're stuck here with an alien. We can't call the government. Because now we're on their... We're on their list or something. Huh, what are we gonna do? This is bad, Clyde. This is really bad. I can't breathe. I'm so freaked out. I'm so freaked out. I don't know what to do. Huh? Hey, he wrote something down. It's not in our language. It's some kind of alien language. Wait. I've seen some of these characters before. Hang on. Holy crap. Whatever language he speaks, it's right here on Google Translate. I can't believe it. Huh? I don't, Oh, okay.
are you, Bunyan? I am what your species call an alien. However, I call you alien.
Holy crap, he learned English just like that! Whoa.
So what's your story?
Several years ago, my planet Oompton, plunged into war and chaos. Seeking refuge, I left the planet and came down here to Earth to seek refuge. But NASA scientists saw me, and the government, using NASA radar, blew me out from the sky, and I landed somewhere near Sycamore Falls. And that's when he found me.
I'm so sorry.
And now I'm stuck here, on this miserable planet.
You mean miserable?
This planet Earth is worse than my planet. They don't know how to get along with anyone.
Tell me about it. Our politics are nothing but a joke. All they do is just bash each other. That's all the parties do.
Excuse me. Can you turn on the heat?
The heat? What are you talking about? We're already at like 90 degrees outside. What do you mean turn on the heat?
Nothing.
So, now that you're free, do you want to get high? Clyde, what are you talking about? You never smoked weed. Well, you don't know, but the viewers do. And in case you don't, go watch Clyde is Relaxed a few videos ago.
What you call weed here, on our planet, we call a batonid.
God, I wish I could unhear that.
I have done this research on this weed. Now let's try it out.
Alright, let's get high. Now let's get even more high. Now let's get even less high. Now let's not even get high at all. Now let's commit arson. Bob, you silly little nutcase. That's not what I meant. Bob is what I named you, by the way, because I don't want to use that very long name. Bob? Bob? Clyde, I think something's wrong. Jeez! He's cold as ice, Blaze! Clyde, that's what the government guy was talking about. Our atmosphere is too cold. His atmosphere is very hot. That's why he kept asking us to turn up the heat. Oh no. Bob! Bob, please answer me!
I need you to bring me back to the place that you found me.
Okay. Okay.
Don't worry, Bob. Everything's gonna be okay. I promise. I'm not gonna let anything bad happen to you. I promise. You're gonna go home. I'm gonna take you up to the mountains. You're gonna go home. Be with your family. Everything's gonna be okay.
We have one adventure to be alive.
Don't talk like that! Please, Bob.
Please hurry.
We got you. Oh, Robert! Robert, come on, wake up, wake up. Don't worry, Robert. I'll get you home. I'll get you home. All right, Robert. This is a pretty big forest. So I need you to tell me what direction we're supposed to go. Robert? Robert?
Left.
That way? Okay. Alright, where now, Robert?
Right.
This way. Where now, Robert? 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 Robert, I need you to tell me where now. Robert?
Stop here.
Huh? Robert. Robert, please, wake up. Robert.